Now we shall discuss the client-side JavaScript after AJAX update. In our last lecture, we have seen how the database is being updated, but the form is not being dismissed, nor is the table being updated. Right now, what we shall do is, we shall see how to dismiss the form. This is where we are at present. This is the table that is visible below, having records, and this is the form that is displayed here, and here is an OK button for the save. We have seen when the user clicks this OK button, the database is updated, but this form is not going, nor is the table being updated. Ideally, what should happen is that the values that were chosen by the user should actually be reflected here also. What we have to do is, we have to, since I'll come back to the code and show you where the things need to be done. This is the template we have written. And in our previous example, this is the function we have added. Now the AJAX data has been posted to that function, and that function is returning a JSON like OK or something else for error in case error occurs. Where is this JSON going? Who is receiving it? This JSON will ultimately be received by AJAX option on success. On success property of AJAX options, it will receive the JSON coming from the server. And where, how will we capture that JSON? For this, we have to specify the name of a function. Let us say we can call that function as update table and pass that data coming as parameter to this. If I write it more clearly, it will be update table data. This data will be the data that is coming from the server, that is OK or error occurred. This MVC will pass this information as a parameter called data. Data is the same spelling that is required. In case you change this, it won't work. Server response will be captured in this function, and this will be a JavaScript function. This function will be written on the index.cshtml page that is showing the table, because updates have to occur on that table. So our next step should be to work on the AJAX options so as to tell what will happen when the database is successfully updated. Let us now specify it. I want to explain this in detail. Like, I'll come to the board here. This is your update table function. One argument it will receive is data. Suppose this is a schematic of that update table function on the, this is JavaScript function that will be called. The second argument should be the ID of the record that has to be updated. The record of the table that is being updated. So that we can use this ID to update the data in that record or the row of the table on the HTML page that is being displayed through index.cshtml. This ID will be used inside the JavaScript function here to update these values. So we'll need ID also, and